Hello and welcome to All Star Online Season 4. And this week we are joined by the 2016 World Barista Champion from Taiwan, Berg Wu. Hello, how are you?
Hello, Wen.
Thank you. And we'd also like to thank you to our sponsors, Scotsman Ice and Otfes.
This episode is supported by Scotsman. For over 50 years, Scotsman has been one of the world's leading manufacturers of ice machines. Today, Scotsman continues to be the benchmark of the industry and offers a wide selection of specialist ice equipment and shapes to customers worldwide, with a focus on clarity, purity, low mineral count, and slow melting offerings. Whether you're a beverage professional, barista, mixologist, or bartender, Scotsman Ice is delighted to be a part of your beverage.
So we have a few videos coming up in this episode. We have our all-stars around the world answering some fun questions. We have Berg's signature beverage video as well. And finally, we ask our all-stars about their coffee stories, and please stay tuned. So we first will start with our all-star around the world video and then come back and have a chat with Berg Wu about his coffee career and life in general. Let's go on to the video.
Well, at the moment, actually, I'm drinking a sample of a Kenya natural coffee. It's on the boat now, so we're just waiting until the arrival. It's really good, sweet. Really like it. Almost every season when Kenya is coming, it's one of my favorite times.
I'm drinking coffee. It's Serra Asu wash processed coffee. It's Asia. It's from Cafe Granja La Esperanza. It's roasted by La Cabra, and Serra Asu is my favorite beans of all times. And I drink it every year. I like the wash process, also the natural process, also the XO natural process. Yeah, it's just amazing.
The moment I'm drinking Colombia washed one, Katsura, Ibagué Tolima. From Tolima region, I roasted 2 weeks ago, so it's good, sweet, fruity, floral. That's what I'm drinking as a V60 in the morning.
Now I drink coffee from Panama. Cheers.
Honestly, I'm always drinking a bunch of different coffees. My role in the day-to-day, I'm a green coffee buyer, so I've got samples right now from literally all over the map. I've got beautiful Burundi samples that I've been working my way through. I've got wonderful coffees on the way from Costa Rica. I'm drinking a lot of Cafe Granja La Esperanza coffees from Colombia at the moment. We've got a great natural anaerobic Java that's on our menu, and also a natural mocha from Finca Hawaii. Those are the coffees sitting at home for me right next to my pour over station. So that's what I'm drinking at the moment.
Okay, that was fun. Berg, what is your answer to the question? 所以他问说你现在在喝什么咖啡？
Okay. 我现在在喝手冲的咖啡，那这是一个配方，它的名字叫做黑美珠珠（ （Black Beauty 珠珠）。那珠珠是我女儿做一支配方在店里面贩售。那 黑美珠珠这一支配方，它是用伊索比亚的水洗豆，然后再加上一点巴拿马的水洗的 geisha， 就是花香很奔放的一支配方。
Okay, now we are going to ask you a few questions. So here are the questions I prepared for you. So firstly, what is the coffee scene like in Taiwan, and how have you seen it change over the years?
台湾在早期的咖啡文化是受到日本有很大的影响，所以早期台湾的咖啡店比较像是在日本所谓的吃茶店，是一个 我觉得是一个大家在那边聚会的场所。嗯，那这几年台湾的咖啡店的形态开始做了很大的改变，是许多人从到咖啡店去单纯的比如说在那边念书啊或聚会，变成是真正的在咖啡厅里面品饮一杯咖啡的味道。那这样子的咖啡店的比例越来越高。
And next, how did you first get into the coffee competition?
我最一开始参加比赛的话是从大概2000年、2001年，都是从一些咖啡店他们自行举办的小型的手冲竞赛开始的，或者是一些创意咖啡的竞赛。那到2009年的时候我才开始参与比较大型的比赛，那一开始就是从台湾 Barista Championship 开始，台湾的选拔赛，大概是这样子。那咖啡师大赛我一路比了七年，那最后才拿到 WBC 的冠军。
那冠军是几年？台湾冠军几年？
台湾冠军的话是2013、2014、2015，连续三年。那台湾的话都是年底比赛，所以是取得隔年的 WBC 的代表权。
So next question, what are your favorite memories from competing?
其实还蛮多的，那多半都会跟人有关系。比如说在一直以来在参赛的过程，我都有很多人在帮助我，那包括我自己团队里面的人，店里面的同事也好，那我们很习惯去一起做练习，所以这些练习都是在开咖啡店的过程不太会遇到的。比如说为了熟悉不同国家的牛奶，不同类型的牛奶，我们会一次收集比如说30种厂牌的牛奶，然后去杯测牛奶，然后试着去记忆这些牛奶我们要怎么去分辨它的不同，然后到了陌生环境我们能够怎么去很快速的选择。
So I know that you also competed in coffee in good spirits too. So how different is that compared to WBC?
我觉得咖啡调酒的比赛的限制比 WBC 要来的少很多，关于在使用的材料上面，或者是你制作的一些方法吧，就是都限制都少很多，所以很能够去展现选手本身的特质。那再来还有另外一点的话，就是它有点像是咖啡厅跟酒吧的差别。我觉得酒吧在顾客服务上面是走的比咖啡更前面的，所以他们不只是针对豆子或是酒有一个完整的介绍之外，他们其实很擅长于把一个故事的情境融入到他的作品和展演里面去，所以是很好玩的一个比赛。
So Berg, do you want to tell us about this photo? Where is this? Is that competition routine in your cafe?
这个场景是在Simple Cafe 的店里面。那这张照片的故事是这样，就是我们在开店的初期有常常就是遇到有一些地方我们不是很满意，所以我们会公休，然后去进行一些工程上面的调整。那我们就借这样子修店的机会举办了一个小型的冲煮竞赛。所以店里面的同事他们可以选择自己喜欢怎么样的器材啊，咖啡豆啊，然后去冲煮咖啡，然后煮给评审喝。那在图片里面坐在前面当评审的三位啊，都是我们店里面有派出去比赛过的选手，所以他们变成转换身份成评审。那这个比这样子的一个小小趣味性的竞赛，其实对店里面的向心力，或者是展现个人的一些工作以外的特质，我觉得是很有帮助的。那我们后续在做很多活动的时候，其实都可以 从这一次的小小的趣味竞赛里面去找出我们每一个同事适合有没有什么人的特质是适合做哪些事情。
Okay, now, so we're going to check out Berg's signature beverage video. Berg, would you like to introduce it a little bit?
这一次我想要带来一个创意咖啡是关于台湾的。那这个创意咖啡的饮品是从我们店里面很受欢迎的一个饮品去做一些小小的改变来的。它的名字叫做南岛烟熏冰咖啡。那南岛的话指的就是这一杯创意咖啡里面的原物料都是来自于台湾这个岛屿比较南部的一些盛产的东西的原物料。那包括了像艾玉，它是一个台湾特有的一种食材，然后或者像冬瓜茶，它也是台湾就是为人所知的一个食材这样子。那我会用这几个材料来做一个很清爽适合夏天饮用的创意咖啡。
Hi, I'm Berg Wu, 2016 World Barista Champion from Taiwan. Today, I will introduce a signature beverage called Smoky Southern Island. As you know, Taiwan is a beautiful island and famous for street foods. So, I will use some special ingredients from the southern part of Taiwan to make a really delicious coffee for all time. Okay, let's brew some coffee. The coffee base of the beverage will be made from the automatic hand drip machine, Otfes. Today, the coffee is from Ethiopia Yerga Chef Uli Wash Station. This is my customized wash process lot. I use 16 grams of coffee and 150 grams 93 degree hot water to brew the coffee. Let's start.
Wow.
This coffee base will showcase very special and beautiful citrus and floral notes.
Bravo! Wow!
Okay. And now, let's prepare the first special ingredients, 艾玉. 艾玉 is a fruit only grows in Taiwan. We put 艾玉 under the sun until it's dry enough, then grab its seeds to storage. Yes, we are going to use the seed of 艾玉. This can be done with an interesting and traditional method. We are going to wash them. So, put 2 grams of 艾玉into the carton close. And then twist the close into 200 grams of water. You will see some paste coming out, slime-like liquid. Then keep the liquid into a freezer or on the ice. The liquid will gradually become jelly-like. We call it 艾玉冻, means 艾玉 jelly. And the most popular way to enjoy it is just enjoy it with cane sugar syrup and lemon juice. And now, coffee is also ready. Let's cool it down too. The second special ingredient is white gourd syrup. Just add some water, it will become a very traditional Taiwanese drink called Dong Gua Cha. Last special ingredient is homemade Osmanthus syrup. So now, I will add some lovely ice cube from Scotsman into the glass. Grams of white gourd syrup. Five grams of Osmanthus syrup. And 2 grams of lemon juice. Some爱玉冻. It's become jelly-like. Last, add all the wuri washed coffee. The Smoky Southern Island is done. Stir and enjoy.
Fun video. Did you enjoy making that, Berg?
Yes, sure.
So here I have more questions for you, actually. What is it like to compete on world stage for you? How does it make you feel?
我觉得世界舞台是一个很激情的地方，每一次去都超级感动，就是比完都会想哭这样子。 那非常有张力，因为全世界最厉害的选手们都在这个舞台上，那包括还有最厉害的评审们，还有整个后台里面你可以看到许多团队一起在努力奋斗一件事情，那种感觉真的是很好很好，会让人家比过一次就想要再回去的地方。
My next question would be, what advice would you give to someone that is just starting to compete?
我的建议有两个，第一个是每一个比赛都会有自己的宗旨，就是他要达成什么样的目标，那当然也会有规则规章，所以要参加比赛之前就是 必须要把你要参加的那个比赛的规则规章去详读，然后搞懂，因为规则规章有可能只是一些文字，但是这个文字背后可能会有一些更多的含义，所以你可能需要长期的去看这个比赛到底在干嘛，然后去了解它。那第二个建议的话就是，也要去诚实的面对自己。 究竟为什么想要参加这个比赛？因为比赛是一个很高压的过程。那如果你没有很明确的知道自己为什么要比的话，每一年的冠军都只有一个。那也许那个冠军不是你的时候，你要怎么去面对这样子的处境？那认识自己为什么要比的话，会非常有帮助。
So how have the competitions helped or changed you?
我觉得因为我自己有开咖啡店，那参赛的过程，我不断的去把店里面发现的一些东西运用在赛场上面。那赛场这种高压的环境之下，又可以让我有一些省事，然后又回馈到我的咖啡店里，所以这是一个很正向的循环，那有助于提升我们整体的品质和稳定性。 还有一些创新的机会。那对我个人的影响的话，其实在比赛中有两次我受到别人的帮忙。第一次是我在2014年我第一次去比WBC 在意大利的时候，那一次我是第七名，就是复赛比到复赛，就是没有进到决赛。 那我在公布决赛名单之后，我其实在后台就是还蛮难过的，就是也开心啦，毕竟那个时候成绩已经算是台湾有史以来最好，但是还是情绪很激动。那个时候，萨尔瓦多之前的一个 WBC 冠军叫做阿汉佐，他就是有跑过来，然后他就跟我说，他有看到我的比赛，然后他觉得我，他看到我有一些很特别的人格特质。 然后他觉得很棒，那他希望我就是继续比下去，所以他那个很简短的谈话其实帮助我，对我的帮助很大。我当下就决定说，那我要再继续比。那第二次的话，其实是类似的情况，但是是我的战友啦，就是加拿大的 Benfoot的话，他们也是他跟他的团队也是在同一年2014年的时候就有参赛，那。 隔年西雅图在西雅图的 WBC 的时候，我初赛就是有失误，所以就连复赛都没有进。那他也是就是跑过来跟我说他觉得以选手来说，只有自己知道自己尽了多少的努力。那收获其实都在过程里面。他觉得被淘汰，他也看过我的比赛，他觉得比去年又更进步了很多，所以再继续下去就会有好的结果。那 其实都很感动，所以他对我的改变就是，我后来也很愿意，对于一些我喜欢的选手，然后或喜欢的后进，我会尽可能去协助他们，或即使一句话，就是尽量鼓励他们。
What are the things that keep you busy this day then?
这几年我其实把工作和那个家庭。 就是尽量找到一个平衡点，所以店里面的事情我都是会去培养一些同事，就是让他们可以一直不断的接手我现在在做的事情。所以在公司方面的话，我变成主要在忙的是对外的一些合作的开发，或者是一些。 不同于店里的一些像展会啦、摆摊啊这一类的活动。那同时的话，我也花了非常多的时间在陪我的小孩，每天都是就是尽量抽出时间陪陪他们这样子。Thank
you for answering all of our questions, Berg. We would also like to thank you to our sponsors, Scotsman Ice and Otfes. We're going to our next video now, which is our coffee story segment. We have reached out to a few people in the industry to ask them how they first got into coffee. We all have our own coffee stories of how and why, and I hope you enjoyed it.
I'm really glad that I can work at Cafe Room for 7 years with Cappuccino, with Don, with Benny. They are my mentor in coffee. And so, yes. And also, it is the first coffee shop I have worked at Hong Kong. So, this is how I get into the coffee industry and the coffee world. And I met the amazing barista. I learned a lot from them. And yes, I just really pleasure to work with these guys and learn from them.
Great video, Berg. What is your coffee story? And how did you first get into coffee?
我一开始是在那个念大学的时候，本来都是去一些咖啡店，就是买咖啡喝。可是后来就是觉得花费太高了，所以才开始尝试着买一些简单的器材。我还记得我第一个器材是法国鸭，就买了一个法国鸭，那在那个宿舍里面尝试着煮咖啡。那因为一开始就煮的非常的难喝，所以就开始产生好奇，到底做错了什么？那怎样可以让咖啡变得更好喝？至少像我在外面买的一样。所以在这个摸索的过程里面，慢慢的就对煮咖啡这件事情产生兴趣，然后才一路走到现在。
Okay, thank you, Berg. Don't forget that on Thursday, Berg will be live on the Barista Guild Instagram Live.Where he will be chatting some more about his coffee career. And see you then. We hope you enjoy the show. Berg, would you like to say goodbye to the audience?
Bye bye.
Bye.